Today I was asked to cut out some plates in trade for some supply, and I'm learning quite a bit along the way. I've never cut metal this thick before. And the first most important thing I learned today was to clean off the slag off the top. All of the pressures had been calculated previously when I did the G-code and left it in the notes. Victor has a pretty cool chart I'll leave some notes to that you can see for inches per minute and pressures you're going to run at. These parts here are hooks, and I don't know exactly what they do, but they're an inch and a half thick and they have to be reasonably close before they get remachined again. When I programmed this in the G-code, I put lots of stops in there, just so I could pause, light the torch, and make sure everything's going good before I hit start. Not shown on camera, I'm about to hit start on the computer, and just before I do that, I'm going to manually turn on the torch by hand. Today I'm cutting with a number 2 tip at roughly 11 inches a minute. Now of course, before I started cutting the other one, I let it run a pre-cycle over top at normal speed without cutting, just to preheat the metal. Stay tuned to the very end. There's a few small mistakes that were made while I was cutting this, and we're going to go over why. If you're into a wide variety of shop processes and learning stuff, you might want to hit subscribe. I do quite a bit of different stuff in my shop, including casting, cutting metal, and machining as well. Now, before I started cutting, I didn't take the time to clean the tip, and I am kind of regretting it about now. As you can see, it's not quite blowing all of the metal straight through, but it does leave, for the most part, a straight cut up until this point. From here on in, the tip for some reason starts to go off a little bit to the left and isn't cutting quite straight. However, the part is still salvageable, and after I did clean the tip and it did cut straight. Now let's take it out and have a look. I showed this part to a friend of mine, Kennedy, who's a very good welder and millwright, and he had a good look at it. The bottom part here that you're seeing is due to the fact that the tip was dirty and I was going a little bit fast. What you're seeing here on the left side is due to the fact that it was going a little bit too fast for the initial beginning of the cut. Coming up next, I'm going to do some free hobbing, making a gear for my lathe.